certainly seems like there is a point when you have finally learned to keep your kite in the air, and you can go back and forth, and you can land it, and you can describe square corners in the sky, and there's a bit of a wall there, and on the other side of that wall is a whole bunch of neat stuff that a lot of people never get to see, especially if they're in areas where there aren't experienced flyers doing cool stuff.
Mark needs all the slack he can get flat for a 540, so you can see that he really gets his hands and arms back. The flare requires a real lunge forward. Here at the end of that lunge, you can see one hand back and ready for the tug. Just letting the line go tight won't be enough for the 540. Give the line a sharp snap back just at the moment it would go tight, like this. Now maintain slack as the kite rotates a full 540 degrees. Let's look at it with all the pieces put together. You can pull a 540 anytime the kite is pointed downwards and in flight, so a great variation is the belly spin out of a downwards turn.